Muy buenas a todos, desde Hamnubis Gamer de Eduardo nos encontramos en un nuevo vídeo del Kingdom Comes Deliverance. Nos han pegado una paliza. Nos han intentado robar la espada, básicamente. Y eso, hemos intentado defenderlo con nuestro honor. Y nos han pegado una puñetera paliza. No sé qué narices está pasando. Porque no me puedo mover. What the fuck? Se está bugueado, se va para todos lados, menos para el que quiero. Vale. A ver. Te pincho, Vale. Hay que seguir. Vamos, vamos a correr un poquito. Lo de mis padres no lo he grabado, ¿vale? En plan, lo de que les tenía que enterrar y tal, no lo he grabado. Pero no pasa nada, simplemente he ido al pueblo donde no estaba en principio. Estaba todo lleno de saqueadores, he matado unos cuantos. Bueno, todo lleno, había unos cuantos, vamos. Y nada, me he encontrado... Bueno, ahora lo digo. Vale, y eso, que me he encontrado los matones esos que les han matado el ejército que ha venido a ayudarme y ya está, simplemente he peleado con él, con uno de ellos, me ha vencido de un golpe, básicamente. Y ya está. Recuerdo que en el anterior capítulo, no sé si lo grabé.
Where am I? In Scalitz?
We're at my uncle's mill in Retay. I didn't know where else to go.
What happened?
You don't remember anything? I suppose that's not surprising. I found you in Scalitz after those bandits attacked you. I thought they'd done for you. But you were still breathing. Why in heaven's name did you go back there? It was madness. You slaughtered everyone who didn't run.
My parents. I wanted to bury them. I had to...
Don't worry. I took care of it.
Thank you.
Any good Christian would have done the same. Now sleep. You need your strength back.
Vale. A ver qué es lo que pasa, porque recuerdo que, no sé si lo grabé o no, cuando quería escapar del castillo robé unas cosas y me pillaron y me encarcelaron.
It's near midnight. You've slept all day.
Oh. Oh, I feel like a horse fell on me.
The beating you took was worse, but at least the fever's broken.
How did you manage to save me?
You were lucky. I was in Scalitz and I saw Zbyshek and his thugs. I tried to distract them, but it would have been no use if those soldiers from Tamburg hadn't arrived. They were searching for you and scattered the bandits.
What in the world were you doing in Scalitz?
Waiting to die.
What?
They killed my brothers, my family, my friends.
They're all dead.
All of them. Everyone I ever loved. They killed one of my brothers in the mines. After that, what did I have to live for?
Don't say that. There's always hope.
No, there isn't. But it doesn't matter. I'm a different person now.
Searching for me?
Yes. Lord Divish sent them, led by Captain Robart. So tell me, why is a lord of such high standing interested in a blacksmith?
Sir Divish promised Sir Radic he'd look after me. But as for why they should care, I've no idea. Oh, I'm exhausted.
I'm not surprised. I'll bring you water and something to eat. In the meantime, rest. You're still very weak. Good morning to you. How's the invalid today?
Ugh, haven't felt as good as this since they lashed me to the wheel and quartered me on the town square.
Got your sense of humour back. You must be better. My uncle will be glad to hear it. I had a job persuading him to let me bring you here. If he'd lain around much longer, he really would have dumped you on the town square. You can stay until you find somewhere else to live, but my uncle will want payment for taking you in and caring for you.
And this is your uncle's house?
We're in Rattay Mill, my uncle's miller Peshek. He took me in and...
Bueno, si esto lo he preguntado antes, de todas formas. Vamos a pasarlo rápido porque esto es que nos ha dicho antes que era lo del molino. Vámonos.
Uncle will be pleased he's one mouth less to feed. But are you truly well enough?
Well enough to do what has to be done. Where can I find Sir Radzig?
He's in the lower castle in Perkstein. He's a guest of Sir Hanish of Lipa. But someone like you can't just walk up bold as you please and demand an audience.
I know Sir Radzig, and I didn't bring him his sword as I was supposed to. I must see him.
If you insist, but you need to speak to my uncle first. You've been in your sickbed for over a fortnight while he paid the apothecary to tend to you, and for medicine. That's a good deal of a coin you owe him.
I've been lying here 2 weeks. My God.
Better a fortnight in bed than an eternity in the grave. If it weren't for my uncle, you wouldn't be here at all.
Os debo la vida.
Both my life. And I'll repay my debt. You have my word.
All right. But before you go to town, you should eat something. You're still weak. There's food on the table for you.
Vale, el molinete es el nuevo hogar del personaje. Aquí se puede dormir siempre que se quiera. También se dispone de un baúl. Los contenidos del baúl estarán disponibles en todas las casas y viviendas alquiladas. El baúl será este. Comer del caldero, vamos a comer. Recuperar la espada de padre, encontrar al jefe, vale. ¿Cómo vamos de hambre? Saciedad 55. Vamos a comer un poquito más. Soltar. A ver, no se puede coger. Cocinar objeto. Venga. Vale, pues no puedo cocinar nada. Muy bien. De todas formas, tengo yo mucha comida. Ah, no. ¿He perdido todo? ¿O está aquí? Ah, vale. Tomamos todo. Vale. Y vamos a ver objetos, armaduras. Vamos a ponernos la bufanda. ¿Esto qué significa? Ah, que está todo reventado. Vale, pues el camisón. Esto. Eso es que está manchado o algo así. Es que no lo sé. Las zapatillas, los guantes, el chaleco y el pantalón. Vale. Y de armas, pues me pongo esta. Y vamos a comer un poquito. Comer. Saciedad 61. Vale, vamos a coger esto. Un salami. Vale, pues ya estamos. Vamos a salir. Perfecto. Cerramos la puerta como buen huésped. Y tenemos que ir... Espérate, antes vamos a quitar la marca que hay en el mapa. Ahí estamos. Y debe ser este buen hombre. Vale, pues hablemos con él. Me llamo.
My name's Henry. Thank you for taking care of me here.
My name's Peshek, and I'm the miller here. You've already met my niece, Teresa. She took care of you for 2 whole weeks while you were in limbo, and talking of you being at death's door. While you were lying here, you worked up quite a bill with the bloodletter, who came now and again to keep you alive with his potions. That quack doesn't come cheap. I paid him what I could, but I still, that is, you still owe him.
I see. Well, it's better to be in debt than to lie dead in a ditch. What do I owe? I'm not afraid of hard work.
You won't pay for that shoveling manure. I might have a better job for you. And it's not something any fool can do. If you prove to me you're a clever lad, I might trust you with something you could really make money from. What do you say?
¿Puedo pagar directamente?
I'll just pay you instead.
I'd say you're a fucking ungrateful pup. But if you think you got money to throw around, so be it.
Vale. No tengo tanto dinero.
I don't have that much.
Then come back when you have.
Contadme, venga.
A trifle. Just to take something from someone and bring it to someone else.
That sounds straightforward enough. Except for not get caught. Why would anyone want to catch me?
Oh, don't worry. It's just a job like any other. Only this one requires, let's say...
No honorable man should touch them. That's the exit.
Did you expect I'd give you a hoe and send you out to the fields? You could dig all right, but somewhere else. I want to know whether you're going to hide me.
I was prepared for just about anything, but that's a bit much.
Listen, it's about this ring my mate, Wojtek, the Kohelnitz Miller, had his eye on. Trouble is, they buried the ring by then.
Jesus Christ. You want me to dig up a corpse, take a ring from it, and give it to your friend...
Money first, morals later. That fellow is dead. He won't miss it. Whatever bleeding heart. Still a human body, only it's missing a soul. Why be disgusted by...
I think I've already heard more than I need to know. You've got the tongue of the devil himself. If you tried hard enough, I bet you could justify...
Watch your mouth, boy. If there's any problem, come and see me. And here's something on the side to make you...
Thanks. I'll need it. I can't believe...
Oh, and watch out for the executioner and his hounds. They're pretty savage. And I don't just mean the dogs. You can just throw them some...
Pues muy bien. Tenemos que ir a desenterrar un cadáver, tío. Consigue una pala. Imagino que la pala estará en el punto A. No. Vale, la pala te tiene que buscarla por aquí, ¿no? A ver... La pala. Creo que ha dicho de todas formas que estaba en el molino. A ver, vamos a buscar... Una pala. Vamos a lavarnos. Y vamos a buscar la pala. No, esto es para forzar. ¿El molino dónde está, tío? Ahí detrás. Vamos a mirar ahí detrás. El molino tiene que estar en el agua, pero... A ver, vamos a mirar. Tiene que estar... Mira, no está aquí. ¿Y no se puede abrir esto? Pues... Vamos por aquí. Vale, a ver, aquí. No, aquí no hay nada, tío. No encuentro la puñetera pala, tío. ¿Qué fetiche tienen estos creadores de videojuegos con palas, tío? ¿Puedo cagar, en serio? Qué tontería, ¿no? Le voy a sentarme aquí. No veo palas. Aquí he metido ya. Y aquí no hay nada. Vamos a ver aquí. Madre mía, compañero, ¿dónde está la maldita pala? Parece que no voy a ningún sitio por aquí, pero bueno, vamos a subir. ¿Para qué coño hay una escalera si no puedo subir, tío? Hay una casa, tío. Vamos a ver dónde está la maldita... La maldita pala, coño. A lo mejor esta casa ya no es de este pavo, pero bueno. Vamos a ver. Diario. Misiones secundarias. Ah, vale, esto es una misión secundaria. Has hablado con Persa acerca del tiempo que estuviste indefenso. Las pesadillas me hicieron despertar. Teresa aleja del molino de Scarlet y estaba sentada junto a mí. Resultó que fue ella, junto a Sir Roy y sus hombres, los que salvaron la vida. Después me llevó a Rataj con su tío Peskek, el molinero. Cuidaron de mí, no sé qué. A ver a Raif y decirle lo que ha ocurrido. Tengo que encontrar al desgraciado que me robó la espada. Creo que la llamaban Tapón y tiene alguna relación con... He de encontrar a Markov y vengar a mis padres. Vamos a activar esta. Desactivamos esta. Y la activamos en el mapa. ¿Dónde está el mapa? Vale, pues... No entiendo dónde está. Es decir, venganza. No la puedo activar todavía. Por lo que parece. Así que tenemos que ir primero aquí. Pues vamos para allá, ¿no? Es por allí, parece. Así que vamos para allá. Tío, un puñetero caballo, tío. Vale, vamos para allá. No me gusta, hago mucho ruido, tío. Me voy a quitar esto. Luego me lo pongo. Vale. Pues a ver, porque tiene pinta de que está lejos. No sé si ir por arriba, por abajo. Vamos a ir por arriba. Venga, por arriba. Siempre me puedo tirar, pero no siempre puedo escalar. Aunque me quiten vida, entonces. A ver. Bueno, está cerquita. Imagino que será este castillo, ¿no? O será nada que esté detrás. A ver. Recuperamos. Ta 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 tam. Punto de viaje rápido. Vale, pues ya tenemos un punto de viaje rápido aquí. Así que perfecto. Vale, me van a parar los soldados, ¿no?
Who are you and where are you going?
I'm Henry, son of the Scarlet's blacksmith. I'm going to see my liege, Sir Radzi Kabila of Tvoyets.
Of course you are, lad. And I'm the Pope. What do you want from his lordship and what makes you think he'll see you?
Soy el herrero de Sir Radzi.
Come on, I'm not some peasant. I'm Sir Radzi's blacksmith and I need to speak with him.
It's my job to stop you.
¿Qué dices, compañero? Pero si tiene mazo de todo, ¿cómo le gano?
Maybe a little coin would clear the way. How much do you want?
Nueve monedas, venga.
What about this?
Come now, just a little more and we have a deal.
Vale.
See how nicely we can get along.
Perfecto. Perfecto. De todas formas, vamos a hacer una cosa. Me voy a quitar el chaleco de cuero porque está reventado. Oh, es que la camisa verde también está jodidísima, tío. Nada, pues me dejo el chaleco de culo, venga. Vale, es por aquí. Otra vez, tío. ¿En serio voy a tener que pagar otra vez?
On my soul, it is him. What are you doing here, lad? We thought you were done for.
Me atacaron unos bandidos en.
Bandits attacked me in Scalitz.
And why, for God's sake, did you go back there? Who else but cutthroats and banders did you expect to find?
I needed to bury my parents.
Oh, I see. Your father fought like a lion. I'm sorry.
He saved my life.
And not just yours. He was a good man, and you did right to bury him.
I didn't even manage that. I failed to save him or put him to rest.
And just what could you have done at Scalitz? If you'd tried to fight, the both of you would be dead. He gave his life for yours, Hal, so you'd better make good use of it.
You're right. And just what are you doing here?
I must speak with Sir Radzik. Is he here?
He's in the palace with Sir Hanush of Ratai. They're feasting in the Knights Hall. What do you want with him?
My father made him a sword. He asked me to deliver it to Sir Radzik.
I don't see any sword.
No. Bandits attacked me and stole it. I need to tell his lordship what happened. And then I'm going to find the sword.
Of course you are, Hal. Good luck.
Thanks.
Vale. Pues vamos a pasar a contárselo. Y me gustaría comprar comida, tío. O sea, ropa. Guau, qué caballo más bonito, tío. Ropa nueva, tío. ¿Tengo que hablar con este hombre o qué? ¿Dónde coño están? Tendrá que subir más, a lo mejor. Vale, tiene pinta de que es aquí, ¿no? Vale, perfecto. Pues nada.
Your graces, I have to tell you in all seriousness that this land of ours is in the shit. Deep fucking shit. Don't you agree?
I might not have put it as eloquently as you, Hanush, but I've been driven out of my own castle, so I'm hardly going to disagree.
Indeed. But Birkstein is yours for as long as you need it. There's room enough for your men. You here at Ratay, and I'm sure my ward won't have any objection to me lending you his castle.
I'd be honored. Pechstein is at your disposal as long as you wish, Your Grace.
Just as well you have another castle at the other end of town, eh? At any rate, I'm beholden to you, Sir Hans, and to you, Sir Hanush.
I don't like to speak ill of your people, Sir Radzik, but, well, there's no love lost between the townsfolk and the refugees. There's been talk of criminality.
No, they'll have to get used to it until the situation's resolved.
But when will it be resolved? And what on God's earth is this war even about? I won't lie, sir. I don't understand it.
You aren't alone, Father. I believe Sigismund's original intention was to persuade Wenceslas to accept the imperial crown and to leave the rule of Bohemia to him.
Who could blame him? I know Wenceslas is a friend of yours, Radzig, but even you have to admit he brought it upon himself.
I can't deny the king neglected affairs of state for other pursuits. There is a need for order in the land, but I don't think the lords who sided with Sigismund realize just what Hungarian order looks like.
Hungarian order.
What concerns me, sir, is how a good Christian could resort to such brutality.
To give him his due, I don't think he expected the lords of this country to stand behind the king. But thanks to him, we're tearing ourselves apart, and now he has to get things under control.
But why in God's name does he have to use those barbarians?
Money is the root of all evil, young sir. Wars are costly, and this one has dragged on for a year. Sigismund ran out of coin for knights, so he recruited those whore sons that settled in Hungary. The less he pays, the more they make up for it with plunder.
That's why he attacked us. He was after our silver.
What are you doing? You've no business here. Clear off.
Wait, it's Henry. Henry, who disappeared after I clearly ordered him to remain at Taunberg.
I'm sorry, sir, but
had to bury my parents.
Had to? Do you think you were the only man who lost someone there? But the others listened to their lord.
And it wasn't just your own life you nearly threw away. So Robard and his men risked theirs to save you.
I'm sorry, but I had to.
Oh, there you go. When you have to, Radzik.
Your father was a remarkable man, and your mother, she was remarkable too. They deserved a Christian burial. Did you manage that at least?
No. I was attacked by thieves. I wouldn't be here now if it wasn't for that girl.
Girl?
The miller's daughter, Teresa.
The miller's daughter saved you from the footpads? Well, there's a tale to tell your children.
I owe her my life. She distracted them and then brought me to Rattai. But without Sir Robard, we'd both be dead.
Well, that's what I call a good woman. Hang on to that one, lad.
Still, it's a great shame your parents are buried in unconsecrated ground. That means purgatory for them.
Be quiet, Friar. I didn't invite you here to eat me out of house and home and deliver a sermon while you were doing it.
If you're so concerned, Father, maybe you should save the innocent souls of these fine Christians yourself. Go to Scalitz and consecrate their graves. I assure you, if you're killed by bandits, your soul will soar straight to heaven, as long as someone buries you in consecrated ground first.
If there's anything left to bury, that plump carcass of yours would be quite a feast for the wolves and the crows. And one skeleton looks much like another, so how would we know which were your ordained bones or those of Sigismund's Tartars?
Be that as it may, why have you come here?
I must get your sword back.
Sword? My sword hangs here at my side.
No, the sword my father forged for you. One of those thieves stole it from me.
They almost killed him and he already wants to go back.
Takes after his father, I suppose. Lad, I've lost a castle, a village, silver mines, and a good half of my subjects. Why would I miss one sword?
Because it's the last one my father forged, and I promised him I'd deliver it to you.
I understand. I'd feel the same way. But prudence is the better part of valor, and a dead man keeps no promises.
Aye. The woman had to save his fat from the fire, and now he wants revenge. What kind of fool are you, boy?
He's no fool. Henry, you have courage. But you need training, arms, a horse. Or do you mean to beat this thief at dice?
No, sir. Please, take me into your service and give me the chance to learn these things.
The gall of him! Fled from the enemy, disobeyed your orders, duped Sir Divish, lost your sword, put Sir Robard in danger with his actions, and now he wants a promotion!
Sir Capon's right.
What you say is certainly true, except for fleeing the enemy. You would have run as well, believe me. Henry's earned some punishment, but how do you punish someone who's already lost everything, hmm? Courage and blind obedience are good qualities for a soldier, but a wise man also appreciates loyalty, perseverance, and determination. Besides, that was a fine sword that his father made. If he thinks he can get it back, I won't turn it down.
My lord, he's a peasant. You can't make a squire of a peasant.
Why not? Someone made a priest of a pig.
He isn't a peasant, Father. He's a blacksmith, and recent events have left me in need of his skills. So, you'd like to enter my service?
Sir, I... Yes, I would. You won't regret it.
I probably will. I'm doing this for your father, lad. Don't disappoint me.
Oh, fortune has finally smiled on you today, lad. Make the most of it.
Now that I think about it, Sir Hanush, the boy needs training and experience, and you need spear carriers.
That's true. The bailiff is always complaining about your people making trouble in the camp. Maybe one of their own among the guard might help.
It might. In any event, it will prove valuable experience.
But let's be clear. You're the one paying him. Captain Bernard, see to his training, and then send him to the bailiff.
Yes, sir.
And don't spare him.
You can rely on it, sir.
Don't forget, Henry. Don't disappoint me.
I won't, my lord.
Vale, pues chicos, aquí comienza la verdadera historia. Nos convertimos de herrero campesino barra, ¿sabes? Las dos cosas a soldado. Tengo que seguir a este hombre, pero eso va a ser en el siguiente capítulo, chicos. Espero que os haya encantado este de aquí. Si es así, manita arriba, like, suscribiros al canal si no lo estáis. Y nos vemos en el próximo vídeo. Adiós.